Hi students, today we are discussing some important questions which was asked in the previous board examination. First question is integral f of x dx is equal to log tan x plus c, then phi of x, find f of x. Here we know that integral of d by dx of a function is equal to the function itself, because integration and differentiation are reciprocal in relation. Here integral d by dx of f of x into dx is same as f of x, differentiating with respect to x. D by dx of integral of f of x into dx is equal to d by dx of log tan x plus c. Log tan x plus c. As I said, integral of d by dx of f of x dx is equal to f of x. Similarly, d by dx of integral of f of x into dx, that is also f of x. What are said? Here, d by dx of integral of f of x dx is f of x. Log tan x is 1 by tan x into tan x, derivative of tan x is x square x plus derivative of c is 0. Therefore, f of x is cot x into c square x. This is the answer. Another question is integral of f of x divided by x square plus 1 into dx is log modulus of x square plus 1 plus c. If find f of x, find f of x. Here also differentiating with respect to x, as in the previous question. D by dx of integral of f of x by x square plus 1 into dx is equal to d by dx of log modulus of x square plus 1 plus c. We know that d by dx of integral of a function is the function itself. That the function is, this is the function. So f of x divided by, therefore, f of x by x square plus 1 is equal. Derivative of log x is 1 by x, so log x square plus 1 is 1 by x square plus 1 into. Derivative of x square plus 1 is 2x plus 0 plus derivative of a constant is 0. So we have f of x divided by x square plus 1 is equal to 2x by x square plus 1. Here we eliminate these x square plus 1 on both sides. Therefore, f of x star is equal to 2x. The value of f of x is 2x, isn't it? Next question is, a is equal to integral of dx by x square plus 2x or minus 2. We should count the coefficient of x. Find the coefficient of x. Take the half of it, so 2 by 2 is 1. Find its square, that is 1 square. Adding 1 square and subtracting 1 square. In such a situation, we have to find the coefficient of x, find the half of it, take its square and the square and subtract the square. Okay. Here coefficient of x is 2, half is 1, square is 1 square. So I am writing this expression as x square, 2x, 1 square, minus 2 and subtracting 1 square, isn't it? Now it can be written as integral of dx by. Here it is in a standard form, a square plus 2ab plus b square and plus b the whole square x plus 1 the whole square. Minus 2, minus 1, minus 3. So it can be written as dx by x plus 1 the whole square minus root 3 square. Now it is in a standard form, integral of dx by x square minus a square. That is 1 by 2a log modulus of x minus a by x plus a plus c. This is the answer. So, using this result, we have 1 by 2a, a is root 3 here, a is root 3, log modulus of x minus a, x is x plus 1, minus a is root 3, again x is x plus 1, plus 4, plus c. Therefore, 1 by 2 root 3 into log modulus of x plus 1 minus root 3 by x plus 1 plus root 3 plus c is the answer. Follow this. Suppose this question, here the denominator has a radical sign. The procedure for doing is same. We put a radical sign here. Therefore, here we have radical sign. Now, we have another formula. Dx by root of x square minus x square. But dx by x square minus x square, root of x square minus x square is log modulus of x plus root of x square minus a square plus c. This is the formula. Therefore, the answer will be changed as log modulus of x is x plus 1 plus square root of x square minus a square, that is x plus 1 the whole square minus root 3 the whole square. But x plus 1 the whole square minus root 3 the whole square is same as x plus 1 the whole square minus 3, which is same as this and same as this. Therefore, the final answer will be log modulus of x plus 1 plus square root of x square plus x minus 2. This is the answer. One question is radical free, another is radical with radical questions. Follow this. Another question is integral of dx square 1 minus 4x minus x square. In this question, the coefficient of x square is negative. So it can be written as 1 minus 4x minus x square can be written as minus of x square plus 4x minus 1. Procedure is as same as the previous question. Find the coefficient of x here 4. Half of that 2 square is 2 square. Now adding 2 square minus of x square plus 4x plus 2 square minus 2 square minus 1. So here it becomes minus of x plus 2 the whole square minus 4 minus 1 minus 5 minus 5 is root 5 the whole square. Now removing this bracket, so here it becomes root 5 the whole square minus x plus 2 the whole square. Therefore I can write as integral of dx square root 5 the whole square minus x plus 2 the whole square. Now it is in the form integral of dx y a square minus x square, that is 1 by 2a log modulus of a plus x by a minus x. This is the formula to find integral of dx y a square minus x square. So we can write this 1 by 2a, 2 into root 5, a is root 5, log modulus of a plus x is root 5 plus x plus 2 divided by root 5 minus of x plus 2. Once again we have 1 by 2 root 5 log modulus of root 5 plus x plus 2 by root 5 minus x minus 2 is the answer. If this question have the radical sign, we put the radical sign. Therefore, we have another formula dx by root of x square minus x square, that is sine inverse x by a. Therefore, here is sine inverse x is x plus 2 divided by root 5. If the question contains radical, then the answer will be sine inverse x plus 2 divided by root 5 plus. Okay. Another question is dx by 9x square plus 6x plus 5. In this question, we have 9 as the coefficient of x. In the previous questions, the coefficient of x square is 1. Here, the coefficient of x square is 9. If so, take 9 as a common factor. x square plus xx 5 can be written as 9 into x square plus 6 by 9 into x plus 5 by 9. Here coefficient of x 6 by 9 half is half into 6 by 9, that is 3 by 9, square is 3 by 9 the whole square. Now we are going to add 3 by 9 the whole square and subtract 3 by 9 the whole square. Therefore it can be written as 9 into x square plus 6 by 9x plus adding on 3 by 9 the whole square. Now we have 5 by 9. Now subtracting 1, 3 by 9 the whole square. Here it becomes in a standard form, that is 9 into x plus 3 by 9 the whole square plus 5 by 9 minus 3 by 9 is 1 by 3, 1 by 9, that is 4 by 9, and 4 by 9 can be written as 2 by 3 the whole square. Therefore, we have 9 into x plus 1 by 3 the whole square plus 2 by 3 the whole square. Therefore, I can write this as equal integral of dx by x plus 1 by 3 the whole square plus 2 by 3 the whole square. That is equal to 1 by 9 is a constant. In the formula, we have 1 by a, so 1 by a is 2 by 3, then tan inverse x by a, x is x plus 1 by 3 divided by 2 by 3. This is the answer. So again we have 3 and 9, 1 by 6 tan inverse 3x plus 1 divided by 2, 3x plus 1 by 3, 3, both 3 are cancelled. The final answer is 1 by 6 tan inverse 3x plus 1 divided by 2. Suppose if this question contains a radical circle, try to find the answer. Okay. Another question is, sin square 2x plus 3. Sin square x can be written as, we cannot find the integral value of sin square x at a. So it can be written as 1 minus cos 2x by 2. This is the formula to find sin square x. So here it is 1 minus cos 2 into 2x plus 3 divided by 2 into this. Here, take 1 by 2. Integral of 1 minus cos 4x plus 6 into this. Now we can find the integral value of this, that is half into. Integral of 1 is x minus. Integral of cos 4x plus 6 is sine 4x plus 6 divided by derivative of 4x plus 6 is
drawing root 1 plus 3. So the final answer will be half into x minus, that is sine 4x plus 6 divided by 4 plus 6. This is the answer. Suppose the question is asked, instead of sine square, if it is cos square, we have the formula cos square x is equal to 1 plus cos 2x by 2. So here put a plus sign. This is the a slight change. Instead of sine square, if it is cos square, the answer is cos square 2x plus 3 into dx, 1 plus cos 2 into 2x plus 3 divided by 2 into dx, 1 plus 1 by 2 into 1 plus cos 4x plus 6. Integral of 1 is x plus sine cos 4x plus 6 is sine 4x plus 6 by 4. That is the answer. Okay. That is the integrated value of sine square x and cos square x are differently by a sine. Isn't it? Next question is y is equal to integral of the xy. X into 1 minus x root of that. Here x into 1 minus 2x is equal to x minus 2x square. Here if we take minus 2 outside, minus 2 into, then here it becomes x square. Minus 2 into x square, minus 2x square. If we take minus, then here it becomes minus 1 by 2 into x. That is x square minus half x. Minus 2 into x square, minus 2x square, minus into minus becomes plus 2 into half is 1 into x is plus x. Now, coefficient of x is minus 1 by 2. X half is minus 1 by 4 and square is square is equal to minus 1 by 4 the whole square, which is 1 by 4 the whole square. Negative square is square is minus 1 by 4 the whole square, so it is 1 by 4 the whole square. Minus 2 into x square minus half x plus adding 1 by 4 the whole square and subtracting 1 by 4 the whole square. First part becomes a minus b the whole square minus 2 into x minus 1 by 4 the whole square minus. Second part 1 by 4 the whole square. Now replacing the minus inside we have 2 into, because square root of a negative quantity is imaginary, so we have 2. Multiply the exact function by this minus only. So it becomes 1 by 4 the whole square minus x minus 1 by 4 the whole square. 1 by 4 the whole square minus x minus 1 by 4 the whole square. Therefore, y becomes integral of the xy square root of 2 into 1 by 4 the whole square minus x minus 1 by 4 the whole square. That is equal to 1 by root 2 is a constant into integral of the x minus 1 by
by 4 the whole square minus x minus 1 by 4 the whole square. Now we use the standard form. Integral of a square root of a square minus x square is 5 inverse x square. Therefore, I is equal to 1 by root 2 into sine inverse x minus 1 by 4 plus c. Once again we have 1 by root 2 into sine inverse 4x minus 1. The numerator becomes 4x minus 1 by 4, 1 by 4 by 4. Both will get cancelled. Therefore, the final answer will be 1 by root 2 into sine inverse 4x minus 1 plus this is the answer. Another question is integral of root of x square minus xx plus 2 into dx, x square minus 6x plus 2 into dx. Here also coefficient of x is minus x, half of minus 6 is minus 3, minus 3 the whole square is 3 square, minus 3 the whole square is same as 3 square, adding 3 square and subtracting 3 square. So x square minus 6x plus 2 is equal to x square minus 6x plus 3 square, we add 1 3 square and subtract 1 3 square. Therefore, it is in the form x minus 3 the whole square 9 minus 2 minus 7. 2 minus 9 is minus 7. And minus 7 can represent x minus 3 the whole square minus root 7 square. Therefore, I can represent integral of root of x minus 3 the whole square minus root 7 the whole square into x. Now the function is in the form integral of root of x square minus a square. Integral of root of x square minus a square is x by 2 into root of x square minus a square minus a square by 2 into log modulus of root of x square minus a square plus. Therefore, I is equal to x by 2. Here x is x minus 3 divided by 2 into root of x square minus a square, x minus 3 the whole square minus root 7 square, isn't it? Minus a square by 2, that is root 7 the whole square by 2, and log modulus of x, x is same as x minus 3 plus root of x square minus a square, replace this term. X minus 3 the whole square plus root 7 the whole square. Not plus minus. Plus c. But x minus 3 the whole square minus root 7 the whole square is this. And it becomes x minus 3 the whole square minus 7, and it becomes x square minus 6x plus 2. So we replace this quantity by x square minus 6x plus 2.
Therefore, I equals x minus 3 divided by 2 into root of x square minus 6x plus 2. Minus root 7 square is 7 by 2 log modulus of x minus 3 plus square root of x square minus 6x plus 2 plus c is the answer. Another question is integral of root of 1 minus 2x of minus x square. Here 1 minus 2x minus x square can be written as minus of x square plus 2x minus 1. Now x square plus 2x coefficient of x is 2, half of 2 is 1, square of 1 is 1 square, adding 1 square and subtracting 1 square. Here we have 1 minus 1. Therefore it becomes x plus 1 the whole square minus 2. Here we removing the bracket and rearranging. So minus into minus plus 2, 2 can be written as root 2 square minus x plus 1 the whole square. Therefore, I is equal to integral of root of 2 the whole square minus x plus 1 the whole square to dx. Integral of root of a square minus x square to dx. Here x by 2 into root of x square minus x square plus a square by 2 into sine inverse x minus a. Therefore, I is equal to x by 2, here x is x plus 1 by 2 in the root of a square minus x square root 2 square minus x plus 1 the whole square plus a square by 2 root 2 the whole square by 2 sin inverse x by a, x is x plus 1 by root 2 plus c. Here also root 2 minus 1 the root 2 the whole square minus x plus 1 the whole square is same as 1 minus 2x minus x. The final answer will be x plus 1 by 2 into square root of 1 minus 2x minus x square plus root 2 square is 2, 2 by 2 is 1, 1 into sin inverse x by x plus 1 by root 2 plus a, that is equal to x plus 1 by 2 into square root of 1 minus 2x minus x square plus sin inverse x plus 1 by root 2 plus c. This is the final answer. Follow this. After watching all the questions at her slide. You find some questions from the textbook and